Good morning, Spanish River. I'm Lagan Thao. Today is Tuesday, May 17th, and this is the last week of regular schedule. Now to the pledge, a moment of silence, and then to the desk with Zoe and Lexi.
Please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated.
Hi, I'm Zoe Wood.
And I'm Lexi Tantliff, and Zoe's going to start us off.
Students, if you are on track and field regular season and you are done competing, please turn in your uniforms to Coach Jane's room, AKA Miss London's room 1136. Uniforms should be clean in a Ziploc with your name written on a paper inside the bag and, if possible, outside the bag. Please get this done as soon as possible before you get a charge on your account. Seniors cannot receive a diploma until all charges are removed from their account. So get this done today. Drop-off should be done in room 1136. Do you need math help? Come get free tutoring during lunch by members of the math club in room 8115 during first lunch and portable 8 during second lunch every Tuesday and Thursday. The cross-country team will be holding a meeting to discuss summer conditioning on Wednesday, June 18th at 6 p.m. in the Spanish River Courtyard. Parents, guardians, students, and athletes, experienced and new, you are welcomed. Please email Coach Horn at douglas.horn@palmbeachschools.org with any questions. Now to Lexi.
Hey, all you sharks that shine. Your Futures Golden Club will be meeting Wednesday during both lunches in room 1134. If you came to our first meeting, please join us again and bring your friends. If you are new to the group, we are students and teachers interested in making Spanish River a more inclusive place. Any questions, please see Ms. Shiner or Mrs. Earle. See you soon. It can be easy to get lost in a textbook and look back over a page only to realize you don't remember what you just read. But luckily, that can be remedied. It helps to pause at the end of a paragraph without a section and without looking, think about what you just stated. Summarize it in your own words. Now glance back over the material to make sure you summarize the information accurately and remember the relevant details. Make a mental note of whatever you missed and then move on to the next section. You may also want to make a bulleted list of important information instead of just rephrasing mentally or aloud. Without looking back at the textbook, jot down the key points of the material you just read. Then look over to the book to make sure you haven't left out any necessary information. Whether you choose to simply summarize aloud or whether you write down the information down, rewording the text is an invaluable study tool. By rephrasing the text in your own words, you can be sure you're actually remembering the information and absorbing the meaning rather than just note copying the information without truly understanding or retaining it. Now to Ms. Castellano.
Good morning, Sharks. We did it. We made it. It was definitely a year, as we'll say, but I want to thank our entire faculty and staff for helping get us through this tough year of transitioning back to face-to-face learning. Congratulations on completing all of your exams. A couple of you have a few left that you need to finish strong on, but for the most part, we are done with the majority of our testing, those tests that are graduation requirements. If you have not taken them, please make sure that you stay tuned for makeups and get in and make up those important tests. Congratulations to all our spring sports teams. Our girls softball team, flag football team came up a little bit short, and we had some track superstars that went all the way to the state level and made the trophy stand. So again, congratulations to all of our spring athletes on a tremendous, tremendous season. I want to remind all of you to be smart as we head into exams, especially if you have 11 absences or more. Remember, you must pass those exams to earn credit. Some of you we will be inviting to our summer school Edgenuity program so that you can get caught up and be on track for next school year and not have to spend a good portion of your day in the Edgenuity Credit Lab. So we will be reaching out to you in reference to our summer program. And I want to remind you that there are no backpacks on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. And we are getting out early on all three of those days. So you come to school similar to the way you did in December, take an exam, have a break, and have another exam. So again, study hard and prepare and have a wonderful, safe summer if I don't see you. And don't forget, there is no school on Thursday, May 19th, as we honor the seniors at the fairgrounds. Have a great day, Sharks.
Bye, Sharks.
We'll see you next year.
Zoe
and Lexi.
Out.